benefits and drivers of DC power delivery system. What are the benefits? Now, in the smart grid, the specter of several potential benefits are driving newfound interest in DC power delivery system. First benefit is increasingly equipment operates on DC, requiring conversion from AC sources. What they are saying? They are saying that increasingly equipment operates on DC. Whatever you take electronic devices that will operate on DC. All microprocessors require direct current and many devices operate internally on DC power. Since so we can go for the DC, okay? DC, every equipment, electronic equipment operates on DC. Then electrical system, but the electrical systems are fed with AC. The equipments are fed with, they are connected to AC. Building electrical system are fed with AC that we convert to DC. Whatever you take fluorescent bulb, we use ballast. AC source to DC source, it will convert. And computer systems also, and we whatever we use adapters for laptops and any other electronic devices. The manufacturer says that electronics manufacturer says that DC is the blood of electronics. So AC to DC conversion within these devices, some amount of waste power, okay, some losses will occur. The power supplies that convert high voltage AC power into the low voltage DC power needed by electronic equipment. For example, we are sending 230 voltage, then it requires 15 voltage for DC voltage, then it will do conversion and lot of power will be wasted. So they are saying that the power supplies that convert high voltage AC power into the low voltage DC power needed by the electronic equipment used in commercial buildings and data centers typically operate at roughly 65 to 75% efficiency. It shows that 25 to 35% of all energy consumed is wasted. So losses are from AC to DC conversions. The rest from stepping down DC voltage in DC to DC conversions. So simply getting rid of the losses from AC to DC conversion could reduce energy losses by about 10 to 20%. So an increasing number of portable gadgets, that is cell phones and personal digital assistants, PDAs, require an AC to DC adapter, which will also result in power losses during conversions. So they are saying that AC to DC conversions is all the equipments work on DC. So increasingly equipment operates on DC, requiring conversion from AC sources. Next is, second one is, in first, they are saying that in aggregate, we can say that the millions of AC to DC conversions necessitated for the operation of electronics extract a huge energy loss penalty. Second benefit is distributed generation system. It will produce DC power. You already know about distributed generation, because being an electrical engineer or a normal person will know about the generation or distributed generation. Many distributed generation sources, you'll be knowing about sources, you'll know about the generation and distribution also, but you don't know the exact name of that. Okay, many distributed generation sources such as photovoltaic cells, fuel cells, and advanced energy storage system, that is batteries, flywheels, and ultra capacitors. This will produce what? This will produce energy in the form of what? In the form of DC power, okay, in the form of DC power. Other devices can also be suited to DC output, such as micro turbines and wind turbines. The energy losses, this is converting from DC to AC power for distribution, it could be eliminated with the DC power delivery, because if we deliver power DC power, then it will enhance and it will give efficiency and reliability and system cost effectiveness also. Next is, third one is storage devices such as batteries, flywheels and capacitor store and deliver DC power. Okay, this will help, how it will help, it will help avoid unnecessary conversions between AC to DC. Okay, these all store battery, flywheel, capacitor, it will stores the DC power and deliver the DC power. So it will avoid the unnecessary conversions between AC and DC. Next benefits is, fourth is, DC power supply could help power hybrid automobiles, transit buses and commercial fleets. Fleets is nothing but conversions. Okay, and there's a nowadays plug-in hybrid vehicles. You already know about plug-in hybrid vehicles. They go, it can go greater distance on electricity than today's hybrid, since because they have larger batteries. Batteries store DC power, so charging them with electricity from solar photovoltaic arrays and other distributed sources, it can reduce, or it could reduce reliance on gasoline. So it enhancing security and emergency preparedness. Okay, when you consider DC power could help, how it will help means for charging also. If it is main supply only DC, then we can charge easily. Okay, so it will help for the charging. DC power could help power hybrid automobiles, transit buses and commercial fleets. Next is, DC power delivery could potentially enhance energy efficiency in data centers, a pressing need. They are saying that most promising potential applications of DC power delivery is in data centers. Applications of DC power delivery is in data centers, which have packed racks of servers that use DC power. In such centers, AC is converted to DC at the uninterruptible power supply. Once again, I repeat, in data centers, servers we use, okay, in packed racks of servers. That packed racks of servers that use a DC power only. So in such centers, what they do, AC is converted to DC by using or at the uninterruptible power supply. Next, to facilitate storage, then it is converted again to push out to the servers, and it is converted one more time to DC. Okay, AC is converted to DC, and again DC is converted, and again one more time it is converted to DC at individual servers. This conversions, lot of conversions will reduce or will waste power and generate considerably heat. Okay, it will generate a heat which must be removed by again air conditioning system. That will lead to high electricity cost. So if these centers install every more dense configuration, that is DC power delivery system, may be, if we use DC power delivery system, then it will reduce the energy wastage and also electricity cost. Next is, Improved inverters and power electronics allow DC power to be converted easily and efficiently to AC power and to different voltage levels. Component improvements enable greater efficiency than in the past. Nowadays, if you can observe that components improvement, it will give more efficiency than in the past. And improve the economics of hybrid AC to DC, AC or DC systems. Improved electronics also enhance AC only. Such enabling technology makes the DC power delivery option feasible as well. Next is, seventh one is the evolution of central, the evolution of central power architecture in computers and other equipment simplifies DC power delivery system. What does it mean? At present, delivering DC to a computer requires input at multiple voltages. For example, one equipment may work for 5 voltage, one equipment work for 10 voltage. So they are saying that delivering DC to a computer, it requires input at multiple voltages to satisfy the power need of various internal components. For example, RAM, processor, etc. Okay. A central power architecture will enable input of one standardized DC voltage at the port. This is a delivery streamlining delivery system design. Next is a DC power delivery may enhance microgrid system integration, operation, and performance. They are saying that number of attributes makes DC power delivery appealing for use in microgrids. With DC distribution, solid state switching can quickly interrupt faults, making for better reliability and power quality. They're saying that if tied into the AC system or AC transmission system, a DC power microgrid makes it easy to avoid backfeeding surplus generation and fault contribution to the bulk utility system. In low voltage DC system, such as it would be suitable for home or group of ohms, a line of a given voltage rating can transmit much more DC power than AC power. While DC circuits have widely used in energy consuming devices and appliances, DC power delivery system are not commonplace and therefore they face the obstacles any new system design or technology must overcome these obstacles. For any of the benefits that is about to the we are whatever we discuss now, benefits, that is benefits and drivers of DC power delivery system. This is research is going on for many years. They are saying I have studied in smart grid subject, that is DC distribution and the smart grid. In that, they say that AC versus DC, one topic is a nice topic, that is AC versus DC power and historical perspective. They say that every power system developer, Thomas Edison, generated and delivered direct current. Okay, DC power system had many limitations. But the power typically could not be practically transmitted behind a distance about 1 mile. You already know about the disadvantages of DC and advantages of DC also. Okay. Yeah, DC is nothing but a continuous flow of electricity in one direction through a wire or conductor. Direct current is created by generators such as fuel cells or photovoltaic cells and by static electricity, lightning and batteries. It flows from high to low potential. Some George Westinghouse says that George Westinghouse polyphase alternating current power system. He invented by Nikola Tesla and used with transformers developed by William Stanley. They worked for Westinghouse, proved to be far superior that technically and economically. The voltage of AC could be stepped up or decreased. Nikola Tesla and William Stanley, they say that AC could be stepped up or decreased to enable long distance power transmission and distribution to end use equipment. Okay. And Edison concept is that for electrification of the US, which included royalties from his patents on direct current system, was to deploy relatively small scale individual DC plants to serve small areas such as the Pearl Street Station, which powered a part of New York City financial district. You just go through once on AC versus DC topic, it will be good. Okay. Alternating current can be, you can observe that alternating current can be produced by large generators, and the voltage of alternating current can be stepped up or stepped down, okay, for the transmission and also for the distribution delivery. And the distance limitation of the direct current and the difficulties of changing voltages proved that critical factors in abandoning DC system in favor of those based on AC. When you compare with AC, DC have the disadvantages because we cannot step down the voltage levels. With DC system, power had to be generated close to where it was used. How we should generate DC power means where they are saying that DC system power had to be generated. We need to generate close to where it was used. This will result in problematic reliability and also economics. So now you have understood what is the difference between DC and AC, that is which is more important, and what are the disadvantages in DC, and also what are the benefits in DC, because every electronic components works on DC. Manufacturer says that DC is the blood of electronics. So I think you have understood somewhat benefits and drivers of DC power delivery system. So in next topic, in next video, I'll try to convey with new topics. So subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.